Temperature and today we discuss about the chromatography. So historical details of Michael Fichte, Russian scientist, separated pigments in green plants leaves using the glass column packed within the 2 micrometers and inulin and lignin mobile phase, coined the term chromatographic. The chromatome means chromo means color, so to chromatome means color, so to writing this to describe the separations of the pigments. Graphy means visualizations, so colored band along with the length of columns. So later used of calcium carbonates and sucrose as a column of packing of materials. Not much work done until the late 1930s. 1941, Arthur John Porter, Martin Richard Lawrence Millingstone published a paper of liquid partition chromatography that sets the stage of for the gas liquid chromatography. Studied amino acid compositions, whole invert process where the liquid chromatography firmly bound to finely granulated solid phase packed in glass column H2O, water firmly bound to silica gel. So a second liquid chromatography immiscible with the bound H2O and procalated through the column and solute analyte molecules are partitioned between the stationary phase and the mobile phase. So historical details, partition chromatography, the problem, the packing of silica gel column is not very reproducible in its properties. Martin and Singe invented a new methods in which H2O is firmly bonded to filter paper. So solute analyte molecules are partitioned between a moving liquid phase and the H2 water bound to the cellulose surface. So very responsible elution times are obtained using the paper chromatography. 1952, Martin and Singe were awarded the Nobel Prize in chemistry for the invention of column partitions. So chromatography and particularly paper chromatography, 1938, Imlay and Skirner worked out a procedure where the solid stationary phase chromatographic phase is distributed as a thin film on glass plate. Thin layer chromatography was not much used until the 1960s when it begins to be used. Chromatography, the gas chromatography was invented in Austria, but was not much used until the 1956. James Martin and James applied gas chromatography to the separations of acids, amines. So small particles are coated with a non-volatile liquid packed into a tube which can be heated. Analytical mixtures are injected into the heated inlet tube and volatilized. So the mixture is driven through the packed column by a compressed gas. So interaction between the components of the mixture and the liquid stationary phase causes separation into zones as the analytes are passed through the column. Major recent advance involves the eliminations of the packing. So coat the inside of a fused silica capillary 250 micrometers ID like a tube with a liquid film 0.10 to 0.50 micrometer thickness. So most recently 530 micrometers ID tubes, mega bores capillarized, are being used. So chromatography definition, what are the definitions? So chroma means color, the graphy means visualization, so color visualization. So definition, the differential migration small components are dissolved in a mobile phase produced by a selectively retention. Stationary phase, classification of chromatography, gas and liquid phase. Like in gas we can divide mobile and stationary phase, so both are divided, gas and liquid phase. In gas, liquid and solid and bonded. So here is liquid, solid and banded, and ion exchange polymer solids. So condition associated with them. Each kind of chromatography, gas liquid chromatography involves in the establishing an equilibrium between the components in the gaseous mobile phase and liquid phase stationary phase. Chromatography conditions associated with each kind of chromatography, gas solid adsorption chromatography involves surface absorption of analytes dissolves in the gas mobile phase. So using the solid phase, solid such as aluminium molecular series or porous silica, and gas bonded liquid chromatography makes use of molecules that are chemically bonded to to a solid support, either silica beds or the walls of fused silica capillary tubes. Interactions between the components dissolved in the stationary phase and the stationary phase involves in the both partitions and adsorption. Liquid and liquid partition chromatography involves in the partitions components dissolving in the mobile phase between the mobile phase and the stationary phase, stationary liquid phase. This is the process associated with the high performance liquid chromatography, paper chromatography, thin layer if silica gel is used, liquid solid adsorption chromatography. So the analytes dissolved liquid mobile phase and the surface of the stationary phase. The stationary phase can be absorbent material such as calmer silica. So chromatography conditions are associated with the each kind of the chromatography. Liquid bond and liquid chromatography involves the silica beds 3 to 5 micromillimeters diameter to which molecules are chemically bonded. The interaction between the analytes and molecules in the liquid mobile phase and the stationary phase involves the both pertaining the adsorption. This is now usually method for the carrying of to HPLs, high performance liquid chromatography. Normal phase of high performance liquid chromatography uses a polar stationary phase and non-polar liquid mobile phase. So reverse phase of liquid high performance liquid chromatography uses of non-polar stationary phase and polar liquid mobile phase. Ion exchange chromatography makes use of the natural or synthetic geolites of synthetic organic and inorganic polymers of resins of the stationary phase. The interaction between the ions of dissolved liquid mobile phase and the stationary phase involves an exchange of ions of associated with the stationary phase. Chromatography conditions associated with the each kind of chromatography, ion exchange chromatography, organic cations, resins, and involves the cross-linked polysystems. So conditions of chromatography, the exclusion chromatography, so makes use of uniform and highly porous and non-ionic gels. So small molecules are retained in the porous of the gel. So large molecules are not retained, they are excluded. Separation involves in the sorting of molecules by size. So gel perform pre-motions chromatography involves use of polymer that swell in the inorganic liquids of polyacrylamide gel. Gel filtration chromatography involves the use of the polymer that swell in the water such as a suffix and a polysucrose polymer. For liquid chromatography, difference in the affinity of solute analytes for the stationary phase can be controlled by the controlling the physical and chemical properties, not only the stationary phase but also the mobile phase. Gradient elution liquid chromatography involves in the changing the compositions of the mobile phase during the elution. Such liquid properties as polarity, ionic strength and pH can be varied. So chromatography column theory cap packed column, the differential migrations analytes in the mobile phase, separations of components of zones move the different ratio dates of along with the column. Observation like bands we can observe and zones gets wider longer, and there is normal distribution molecules concentration along with the length of columns. So chromatography resolution measures how well zones are separated or compared with their overlap, determining the standard deviations of column length and over which the bands are distributed, determine the retention time, how long it takes a zone center. So these are the things: column and efficiency, column sensitivity. Chromatography is a theory of packed of chromatography. So effect of column is sensitivity and efficiency, column sensitivity and column efficiency. Here is column efficiency and column selectivity, and column efficiency and selectivity. These are the poor resolution, good resolution. Here is a poor resolution, here is a good resolution, here also some good resolution, but these are the, because of the good resolution, column sensitivity and column efficiency is poor. Here is poor resolution, here column selectivity is, although column efficiency is good. So these are the things we are discuss about the background and history of the chromatography. Thank you very much.